Hello, and welcome back to a very dairy-enthused engineer. Me, Yogurt. What do I have for you today? Purpose. A purpose in life is what we all search for. What have I found? Nothing. In fact, I've spent the actual time making a calculator that can that can tell you exactly how much pellets you need to pack based on a certain percentage of hardener shells in your cram cannon to penetrate through a given armor layer. Hell yeah, that's what I've done. What's on screen? It's a test rig. This is a cram cannon with a one hardener pellet that's just to represent 100%, and I have a little visual guide here. So that was a very quick intro, but this is a quick vid. Let's go over to the calculator. Okay, I also have to go. So this calculator is what I have made. We will zoom in to make it easier to see. So what are we looking at? We're looking at an Excel spreadsheet that allows you to design a layered armor with layered materials that calculates for forwards armor class bonuses, as well as sort of calculating the amount of kinetic damage on. So from top to bottom, we will design a very simple armor. We'll just do two heavy armor slots. Wow, this is updating very slowly because I'm on a very bad laptop. Also, yes, very bad laptop. Okay, so let's say we want two layers of heavy armor. We have a check function, green is good, red is bad. We have health of the armor, we have the armor class, we have the cost and the weight. This is all just for some lookup tables. Then we have a AC damage multiplier. This is based off an armor piercing value. The health and the total kinetic damage needed to break through the two layers of heavy armor. And then we just have some total values, total cost of all the layers, the weight, and that. And this calculator assumes that you're only using 4-meter beams and the cram cannon is sitting at a 90-degree angle. So, how does this calculator work? Well, let's say you have 100% of your pellets are hardener, 100% of the connections. That means your pellet, your shell, whatever diameter, will have an armor piercing value of 40. This will give you around 14,850 health of your shell, 19,800 kinetic damage, and you will need at least 1,238 total pellets packed to pierce through two layers of heavy armor. Okay, let's remember that. 1,238. And I know that 1,250 pellets packed gives you 20,000 kinetic damage at 40 armor, at an armor piercing value of 40. So 200. Keep that value in mind because we're going to look to see if we pierce out the other side of 200. Okay, over to from the depths. Yes, we're going very quickly. Thing. Two layers of heavy armor. Let's make sure damage debugging is on. Refill the cram cannon. I believe I am on 200. Okay, and simply slow down time, fire pulse. Now we see what happens. So we're looking to pierce through the layers of heavy armor and also come out the other side with a very low amount of kinetic energy. That shows we have an accurate calculator. Okay, you saw that. Right at the end, the shell slows down. There we go, because there's very little kinetic energy left. Let's see what the values are. Fair all. We can see it pierced through the first block with 9,200 left, and it pierced through the last with only 200 kinetic left. Calculator works. Wonderful. So we know if we have 100% of our shells in our of our pellet connections in our cannon, hardener, to pierce through two layers of armor, we need at least 1,238. Let's make a more complicated armor to show that it does work with different layers. So we will do one heavy, then stone, then an air gap, and then something else. Then wood, alloy, air gap, wood, and then three layers of metal. So this is a very standard, very basic, very boring, nothing special, but you have a tough outer layer, a buoyancy layer, and then you have protected internal components. So let's design this armor up in our calculator and see what it tells us we need to pierce through it. So we will go, we have one layer of heavy, one of stone, we have an air gap, then wood, then alloy. We have an air gap and then wood and then three layers of metal. Okay, see ones across the board where we want them, so that's green, that's good. We see the health of the blocks, we see some armor classes being carried forwards. 20% of this layer, very nice, and then we have our damage multipliers. Okay, so if we have 100% of our hardener shells as, our percent of the connections as hardener, this calculator tells us to pierce through all these layers, we only need 1,197 packed pellets minimum. Okay, well, let us, I think we can do that with 1,200. Should only have a little bit sticking together. 1,200 pellets should pierce through all of these layers of armor. There we are. I didn't view that because I knew it was going to do it. That's right. We came out the other end with 53 kinetic damage left. Let's see, actually. 53 was the remaining damage. This cram cannon does 19,200 kinetic damage at 40 AP. And we change this now, 19,200 and 53. And 53 was the remaining damage. So, calculator is correct. We know that you need at least this amount of pellets for the percent for 100%. Let's mix it up a little. Let's say you only want 50% of your pellets to be hardener because you want to penetrate into your target and then deposit a load of high explosive damage into the center of your target or past your armor design. So if you only want to pierce through the first layer or the outer layer, you only put in wood and the three layers of metal and it'll redesign this entire system. So let's actually do that. Let's say we don't actually care about going to these internal components. We only care about getting into the very center, or only care about getting past the first outer shell. So 1,183 packed pellets, with 50% of them being hardener, should crack us through the first three layers of metal and the layer of wood. So it's pretty hard to get to exactly this number, but we can get close to it. With 1,200, so we don't even have to do anything. I am happy. This? Okay, so I'll slow down time now, and we should see the shell travel through all of this, get into this air gap, and then run out of kinetic energy on this piece of alloy. Let me just delete this view box so it really shows how it's working. And we also want 50% of our shells to be hardened. So I will add an explosive pellet. Now we have 50% hardener, 50% HE. We do 13,412 kinetic damage. Hold on, let me just check what's happening here. Oh yeah, okay. All right. And so we'll do 13,400 explosive and we'll be able to pierce through the outer layer, hopefully. Slow down time. Take a pause. Okay, now let us follow this bullet. Ramshell. Okay, it has now pierced through the outer layer. You can see it's probably run out of kinetic energy. It's now going to basically fall and just detonate as it runs out. So as soon as it hits the other wall, it's going to run out of kinetic energy and detonate. Brilliant. Excellent. How nice of it to work exactly as I want. Now we can look at the debugging. See, we have a trigger point, and the trigger, it triggered because the cram ran out of kinetic energy. Very nice. And it pierced through with only a small amount of kinetic damage left and a very low AP. Awesome. So just like that, we can designate a percentage of our shells to be hardener. It can be any percent. And the calculator will automatically calculate the amount of pellets you need total. Total, so that's both hardener and extra, and the other other ammunition types. And you can mix and match, but these estimations are for one singular ammo type. So this calculator is somewhat inaccurate once you start. It's even inaccurate now, but it's approximately the one. Yes, that is how that works. Boom, nice and easy. I hope that was quick. Next part, I have a next section, which is if you want to set up a cram cannon that can resist the amount of lambs or the damage from lambs or from some advanced cannons, this calculator here works off not the kinetic damage required, but the health required. At the moment, all it's doing is it is compensating for the health loss of one fuse of this kinetic damage. But if we say we want a shell with a health of 60,000, with 60,000 health, with 50% hardener, we get a new pellet count. So this is the amount of pellets we need to get to 60,000 health. That is, if there's a certain, like the Alcazar for Onyx Watch does about 60,000 damage with its lamb systems. So we'll know we'll be able to pierce through, or we'll be able to get to it. And then also, we'll just be able to outpower the lambs. But you have a fuse now, so you don't really need exactly the correct amount of... That's just a little extra calculator. But the main one is this calculator. So how this also works is for the armor design, it shows that, okay, if we have, say, only 10% of our shell being hardener, we need so much more pellets to have so much higher kinetic damage because our AP drops to almost nothing. But this means that a massive portion of our shell is now high explosive. So we'll be able to pierce through the target into this area through just these three layers of metal and wood, and then deposit all over 150,000 high explosive damage internally into the target. That's one way to design your shell. You simply go, okay, we want to break through, I'm gonna go back to the actual full armor design. So it was heavy, stone, gap, wood, alloy, gap, wood, and then metal. That was the one that I currently have in, from the depths. So we'll say we want to do 100,000 high explosive damage after we pierce through this entire armor stack. And so we will slowly increase this number, this percent of the shell here that is hardener, until this value gets to around 100,000. There we go. So if 30% of the shell is hardener, we only have to pack 7,010 pellets. And we will drop a full almost 100,000 high explosive damage internally past all the layers of armor that we designated up here. And I'll just show how that works. So 30% and 7,100. Back into depths. Delete that. And I'm just gonna put a B so that We'll go over the amount of kinetic damage, and then once it just strikes this beam, it'll explode. So just the tiny little remaining kinetic damage. So we need 3 hardener like so, and then we need 10 high explode. What am I doing? No, we need 7. Okay, there we go. So now 30% of our shell is hardener, and 70% is high explosive. And we need to pack over 7,010 pellets into this cram cannon. Then we have it perfectly designed to crack through. Okay, cool. Get much closer to. There we go. 7,100. Actually, let's. And then see if we get to 7,000. Okay, so now we're much closer. We were looking for a value of 7,010 pellets packed, with 30% of them being hardener. This should mean that we're at 90,000 explosive damage, so my calculator's overestimating. It's fine. This means that we'll have enough kinetic energy to pass through all of these layers, and then without needing a fuse, it will blow up on this internal heavy armor layer. We'll slow down time. Then I will pause it to trigger, and I will pause it. And since we have so many more pellets, the explosion is just going to be a little bit in the way. We'll see if we can catch it on the side. Yeah, we broke through. Then the shell will now drop, and it will run out of kinetic energy and probably blow up everything. Yep. Awesome. Okay. So we pierced through all those blocks, and we exited out the other side with only 330 kinetic damage at 12 armor piercing. That is almost nothing. It's pretty much guaranteed just to run out of kinetic damage at soon. But even if it strikes like a piece of wood. There we go. And well, once it landed and it ran out of kinetic energy, it exploded without the need for a fuse. So you didn't have any issues with losing shell health. Very nice. Okay. Well, I hope that was a quick tutorial on the calculator. I hope it made sense. It's very simple, and it is version 1. So version 2 of this calculator, I will be doing things like engagement distance. So if you're engaging from 1,000 kilometers, I can then simply use a few equations to then interpret sort of engagement distance and muzzle velocity of your cram cannon. And then I can sort of gauge the angle that will be approaching blocks. I will also be, in the version 2, will be able to insert wedges, and then I can do damage multipliers on that. And it'll only probably be 4 meter wedges and, or 4 meter slopes and 4 meter beams, since that's sort of the worst case scenario. And if you design it for the worst case scenario, you will be fine. But yeah, this is a little thing where, so say you have a cram cannon with 1,000 pellets that it can pack, or it can pack 522 per second. Then you know that 157 of your connections need to be kinetic, 365 need to be other, and then total you need to pack 7,010 at least. So that's just a little extra thing. So if you already have a cram cannon with a certain amount of connections, you can input this and it'll show you the balance that you need. Since you can't use the cram ammunition customizer thing in the game, if you have three-dimensional Tetris. If it's two-dimensional, all good, no need to worry. But if it's 3D, you'll have some issues. Okay, well, I hope that was all good. Thank you so much for watching, and have an absolutely wonderful afternoon. This is Yogurt, signing out. Goodbye.